Hi, my name is Andrea Love. I'm the Director of Building Science at Payette, an architecture firm here in Boston, and we are the designers for this new science and engineering complex, the SEC, which is one of the most energy-efficient research buildings in the world. We're really excited about this project. We started it in the summer of 2013, really setting energy targets early and working towards trying to reduce the environmental footprint of the building, looking at everything from energy and water, materials, and the comfort and experience of the occupants. KBUTU stands for 1,000 British Thermal Units, which is a unit that we use to measure energy. We're using about 70% less energy than a typical lab building, which is equivalent to about 400 residential homes a year. We're looking at ways to minimize the heat gain in the building through a high-performance envelope, how to minimize thermal bridging, so creating a kind of tight, comfortable envelope. The facade is a high-performing facade, so we have triple glazing. And the nice thing about triple glazing is that it reduces the amount of heat loss that happens in the winter and minimizes the amount of solar radiation that comes into the building that would increase the cooling load in the summer. It also makes for a more comfortable environment because it has a warmer interior surface temperature, where in many old buildings or buildings that don't have a higher-performing facade, you would need an exterior heating system in the winter. But triple glazing, we don't need that system anymore. So the building is oriented in a kind of 45-degree angle to north-south, so it has kind of a southeast and southwest facade, which is one of the hardest orientations to control sun and heat gain. So we have an integrated shading system in the facade of the office building, as well as little exterior fins to try to minimize that heat gain that comes into the building, which would increase both the energy usage, because once the heat comes into the building, we need to cool it, but also it increases the loads and the system sizing to deal with those loads. We also have high-performing mechanical systems, so using things like chilled beams, radiant panels to efficiently heat and cool the building so that we can minimize the air change rates. Research buildings have high volumes of air that go through for both health and safety, but also to deal with the loads in the space. And typically, because of the chemicals that occur in a research lab, that air is just exhausted out, and all that heat, all that energy that went into heating the air up to a comfortable temperature in the winter, or say cooling it down in the summer, is just thrown out the window as we exhaust that large volumes of air. Because the air is contaminated, we can't typically recirculate it like you might in a classroom or an office building. We spend a lot of time looking at different ways to recover that heat and capture it. So we have a high-performing heat recovery system that captures about 60 to 72% of the heat before it's exhausted out through the building, which really reduces our heating load in particular and a little bit of our cooling load in the summer. And so it's one of our biggest energy efficiency strategies that we have for the project. We also look for ways to connect the occupants to the exterior, so there's a lot of glass to give views, as well as to allow an ample daylight throughout the building, and natural ventilation so that in all the offices there's operable windows to connect the occupants to the exterior, both for energy savings but also to provide that connection to nature. So kind of like you talk about your miles per gallon of a car, we talk about the KBUTU per square foot of a building as a way to compare what building is really energy intensive and which ones are using less energy. The average lab uses about 370 KBUTU per square foot. We set a target early on trying to be less than 100. And so the building is tracking in the 90s. We're very proud that we've been able to realize this goal. The roof is PV ready. At any point, if Tufts wants to put solar panels onto the roof of the building to generate electricity, the building is set up to do so. Research labs are typically also very water intensive through a lot of their uses, as well as the mechanical energy and the cooling towers and things like that, landscaping. So we set up a water budget early in the project to identify all of the sources that we could capture rainwater and where we could reuse it. We were able to really reduce the water usage in the building through efficient fixtures and other strategies so that the building reduces its water usage as well as the energy. The landscaping utilizes drought-tolerant plants to really minimize that water that's associated with the irrigation. And originally, part of the master plan had been to tear down Robinson and actually move Brumfield Pearson to make way for the new building. One of the goals of the project that we had was to kind of preserve those historic buildings. And so not only does it reduce the energy and the water for the complex, but we're saving materials and that kind of embodied carbon of not tearing down those historic buildings on the site or moving them around. The building utilizes many recycled materials with recycled content, as well as ones that are regionally available, to minimize the carbon footprint of the transportation and manufacturing of new materials, to kind of minimize the environmental impact of the physical materials of the project as well.